Hey everyone, this is Tracy with Color Me This. We're on episode 243. We're doing the daily color in small victories. We have a large heart to work on today. Here it is. I will be rotating it. I will be working on one half on the left side. So I am going to rotate and then bring the camera down. Was still up from yesterday. And we're using Artisto 72. The pencils are a hexagonal with a nice sized cord, not huge but not small. The font is less than ideal for the color name, but the numbers are easy enough to read. And they are a little bit firmer, but like a not a buttery, but more of a mix between a silky and creamy. I'm gonna bring it in even more. I decided I had done 3 days of fall colors. We are gonna make this a more traditional red heart. I have 3 color tones. I have reds, I have greens, and then I have browns. It seems with a 72 set, there's always one color that doesn't go dark enough. Today's color is the green that doesn't go dark enough. So I have pulled a special black. This set has 2 blacks. This is called Black Magic 371, and I will use that for shading. It is in essence a very dark charcoal color. So for the reds, we've got, I'm hoping that this stays on the little bit of the pinkish side of red. We have raspberry, 331, berry red, 336, and mahogany red, 324. I am going to be doing all of the colors and all of the flowers. We have 2 kinds of flowers though, so I could vary it if I wanted to. I have this jaggedy middle, or I have the like a teardrop or flame middle, but I think to keep it simple that I'm going to make them all somewhat the same. I might vary how much dark versus the lights, and we'll just see how it goes. Like I said, these have a somewhat a smooth feeling on this paper, but it's not a buttery, so they don't feel like a couleur. They don't feel like a Prisma. They don't feel, they kind of feel like their own thing. I know that's kind of a cop out in a way. Not as silky as a Polychromos. They blend really well. Color palette is not bad. Again, it seems like, though I really like 72 sets for the simplicity, the swatch charts are nice and small, and I get to use these smaller cases, which I really like. I got them in for a really good price a few different times from Temu. I try to target under $6 for the 72 and ideally under $5 for the 50. I even have, I think, 136. I think it was some sweet deal, and it just means it's less zippers than the other two, but they're pretty much the same footprint, just not as thick. So something like this is my plan. As I said, it has been nice doing some simpler designs. That's one thing I love about this book, is that I don't think people go through it in order. This is just my challenge for myself. But it's nice that the book is very organized to give you variety if you did choose to go in order. And I like that. It is probably that reason why I am able to not be burnt out yet. I'm going to move the light in a little bit more. It seems like we've had a little break in our very hot, wet weather. And the next 10 days does have rain, but it's lower than the 90s. It's in the upper 80s. So that's going to be a nice change. These have a little more easy lay down. I just did the Amazon Basics, and I think I like these a little bit better for the pigment feel and the payout. Because I have still not moved any heavier pressure than light to medium. All right, let's go ahead. Oh, this one only looks part way done. I am switching to the middle color, which is our red, and it is a berry red, which is exactly what I was looking for. I wanted the red tone to stay a little bit on that pinkish berry side, not the orange. I like how these colors mix really easily. Again, not using anything more than a light medium pressure. I see some tooth, so it will be interesting to go back in for the final layer to see if I can get the rich payout we all love. So I've never actually mentioned this, but you know, I assume, I don't do speeding up, I don't do the music, and I just figure a lot of videos, if I know the person and I've already watched a few of their videos and I like their style, I just will watch without sound. So I assume that a lot of people maybe watch the beginning where I'm talking about the plan of attack. But then when I get into coloring, I figure most people go on mute. And that's the nice thing, that you can mute me anytime you want. And you can color with me anytime you want. That is the joy of these being available on YouTube. So I would say that for my style of coloring, which is light layering, that these are very, very good. Now, let's see what happens. Can I do my light layering, but still go in and get a vivid result pretty quickly? That we will have to see. I'm now using the lightest color, which is raspberry. I might leave a little more white. The last images I did on the previous page were very small and delicate, and I did not leave any highlights. I think I left some highlights on the top one, in the flowers that actually were shaped like these flowers. These have this extra little small leaflet. This almost looks like a clove of garlic or a turnip upside down. All right, I am going to take, I want to get a little more of this mahogany red laid down. So now I feel the burnishing happening. And the next thing to feel and try is, will I be able to add more color after the tooth is all filled in? So the Couleur, which is kind of one of my baseline, they have a very distinct feel about them, and so when I evaluate a pencil, I kind of go, is it like a polychromos? Is it like a Prismacolor? And I don't use Prismacolor a lot, but I just happen to be working through a conversion master sheet for them. I don't want to be in the conversion chart business, but there are some sets that I have that aren't available on the big charts that are out there. Though I am very grateful to have available what is out there and the people who do them, oh my goodness, more power to them. I want to have a master because for me, the jumping off point I know for most folks is the Prismacolor. They are often used for doing color alongs and such, I use all of my pencils, but if I give you any of my obscure sets or sets that I know don't have a conversion, and then you can cross-reference with the Prismacolors, then go over to those charts as needed to get whatever equivalent set that you have to work with. So I'm trying to make the fact that I change pencils every day be less challenging for you. So hopefully, as I fill in the gaps, it will allow everybody to color with me, no matter what set they have. There should be something similar to their set that they can find the colors for. They're still coming out with more sets. That's why I say should be, because the Chinese sets are still coming. We're still finding a lot of them are a white label. Oh, these are really pretty. I think that I am going to have no problem adding more layers after the tooth is filled in. They don't go all slick. I can feel it, but it's not so slick that you just have no way of putting any more color down. I now want to go back to the very lightest color, which is the raspberry. And now I'm using medium pressure. They blend so well, it's almost, if there was no middle color, I could probably get away with a light bit of the mahogany and a heavier layer of this raspberry. And I think it would all blend. So, I feel that I would like to pop in a little bit with my berry red so that I can get some variation in the colors. Yeah, these are pretty great. I see why. I bought these because Coloring Bliss did a review. I think this was the number 3. It was very highly rated for the criteria that they had, which was budget Amazon sets. The reason why I picked these, I was happy picking any of the top 4. I didn't own any of the top 4, I don't think. And there was a coupon. So that coupon was what picked the winner that was going to be added to my collection. All right, these flowers are looking great. We have this lower set of flowers. I am going to do the whole side. So we're just going to continue on. Now, these, since I've explored them, oh, I should also clarify, I did not do anything to prepare for using these except I have an envelope sitting here, literally from the mail, for some junk mail, and I grabbed it and I did my blends on it. So I wanted to not have to do a mock-up page for this. I just finished doing three other similar images with doing mock-ups for the three because it was a set of three completely different types of pencils. So now this is my challenge of not doing so I'm going to be over here. This is where the knuckle comes into play. I try to keep my knuckle out of things. When I have the knuckle, that's when it will change focus to my hand and not what I am coloring. Again, a little harder pressure for these. The tips I tried to get really sharp, and they are, you know, I'm wanting a really, really sharp tip, but I do feel like they don't hold that sharp tip, not like a, you know, like a Star Joy Gold. My hardest pencils, Prang Star Joy Gold and Erogitin, are the ones that hold. So these aren't like that. Even though they are not as soft as other pencils, they're also not super hard either. Somewhere in the middle, in the sweet spot. All right, so these are, so that's all the flowers for this side. I'm going to move on to the middle tone. I am not feeling like I have to put medium pressure down. This is still pretty light pressure. Look at this one, I forgot. We'll just not put that dark. That'll give it a little difference. I am pausing to put my craft glasses on. Though, because I am so far away, that is the problem I have with craft glasses when I film. I'm at a very in-between distance from the page, so it's not always working for me. Although today, my eye says it is better. Hmm. medium pressure. Wanting to finish these up without a third pass if possible, so I can move on. All right, I am finished with the reds. I'm gonna do the greens. Now the greens, I will say, three color blends are not what the goal was for the greens. They wanted to get, you know, there's green, blue green, olive green, and leaf green, and so they wanted to cover all the bases, so I had a really hard time getting a dark again. So I'm going to try this one for the dark. We've got pistachio 319, for the light middle color basil green 322, we're going to go for pine green 347. I have sitting off to the side the forest green 362, but you can see how blue green. The barrels are somewhat representative, so I didn't want to go that blue, so that's sitting aside. It is dark enough, though. This particular green, the pine, might not be dark enough, but as I said, I have my black magic here. Oh, yep, waiting just in case, and I am going to do all of the leaves the same colors, but I might vary the amount of each color, making some darker, some lighter. We have like five different styles of leaves. We have these little loose teardrops. We have some pothos type leaves is what I think of them as. They're a wide, round-ish leaf. We have some standard little leaves here, a little skinnier, and then we have the cross-hatched leaves. And then we have these little grassy sprigs. So I am using the lightest, and I'm doing just a light wash, kind of like a base. Leaving the tips white. I am not quite ready yet, but I will tell you, I have been watching background videos. I have been watching base videos. I do have an extensive, though not complete, collection of Copic markers. They were collected for many years. I already owned a full set. This is my second collection. They are much less expensive now than the first time I collected them. I have a cohort in crime who finds them on sale and will pick up whatever she can and then split up any of the ones she'll get them home, and whatever she already has, she'll share. I felt that sneeze coming. So, I have amassed quite a few now. I use them in card making. I actually use them to make signs. I do vending of my cards and other crafts that I do. And so I use those to make nice signs. So I do have in my mind that as soon as I finally get to the point where I'm ready to try some different things, more than just colored pencils, which I have now been kind of on the whole colored pencil wagon for a couple, 2, 3 years now. And I have not got a lot of options for basing and backgrounds, but I do have enough. I switched on you. I switched to the basil, which is the middle color. Yesterday, I shared my vision for a background that I want to do for the romantic country book. But of course, it's going to be done in colored pencils. Because I came from the world of watercolor and Copic markers, it was many years ago, but I also used them for many years. I'm just a non-messy, like between Copic or watercolor mediums. I'm going to pick Copic any day because they are not messy. And why I don't want to use them in these books is that they do bleed through. And that's the other thing, that's my new thing. I am into coloring in this book. Between coloring, keeping up with the card making, and swatching and organizing everything, I have my hands full. Look at that. I just don't feel that I did much on this one. I wonder if you can see how lovely these colors are blending together. It's just so easy. Yes, by far, pencils are the cleanest, and I love pencils that do not. Oh, that gives me a. There is no, so far, no crumbs. I do not think on that last page with the between the metallics, the Derwent drawing, and the Amazon Basics, there were no crumbs left behind. So as you can see, I'm just kind of popping around. This is now my third layer. This is again the basil. I haven't even introduced a dark yet. This is just my middle tone. Because I want to see how dark I can get these without the dark. I have the choice of that bluish green. And I might instead want to go straight to the Black Magic. Now we're getting down to the bottom area here. This is the side of the, although it looks really good today, this side I tend to angle. The left side of the clipboard is on the arm of my recliner. The right side, I have a round pillow that props up, and it tends to height-wise not always be consistent because it sits on my legs. And so sometimes I notice the right side ends up blurring on me. So I do prefer coloring in the middle of the screen to avoid all that. If I haven't mentioned it already, I'm doing half. You know, these things in the center I probably won't worry about until I go back and do the second half on my own time. I still am of the same mind as I was on the previous page where I have got these little balls and they will be my bling. I'm thinking to myself what I want to do with the tendrily vine. I am set with some choices that will give me a tanned brown. Which is similar to what I did on the previous page, viney branches. I'm gonna go do another pass with the light. I really love how vivid these are coming out. So I still have in mind that eventually, maybe even while I'm still doing this book, I will want to change things up a bit. I might want to spend a day a week doing backgrounds. I haven't got there yet. Like I said, I'm watching videos. I've done some practice with my coloring group. And I even have, for the review, my friend Don and I made some, I guess, sample swatches that I will share with you that are now nestled in this book to do some testing on the bling that I like. And I'm seeing some wear with the gel pens that I want to test more fully what kind of wear I can expect in this book over time. This book travels all around the house. It went on the airplane with me. It goes in the car with me sometimes if I have some homework to work on and coloring to do. I will bring this. I think I am happy with these greens, and I am not even going to use a dark yet because I want to see what happens with the vines. I have four colors, and I noticed that one of these you'll see. So we've got caramel and what's called cinnamon. This is cinnamon is pretty dark, I guess. But I think the barrel is darker than the pencil color. So I did pull out chocolate and then a dark color, which is actually almost gray. All right, so we've got the caramel, 334. Cinnamon, 337. Chocolate, 355. And dark ash, 353, of which you will see cinnamon and chocolate are awfully close, but I don't think they're as close as you will see. I'm always very careful to leave some tooth. Like here I am just going along with this lightest color. I guess I don't mind using this lightest color if the vines end up looking somewhat like gold versus brown branches. It's kind of a, so you can interpret it however you would like. And this should go pretty quickly. I'm going to go now to the darkest. A lot of times I will start the darkest first, but I wanted to test that light color. It could have turned out very different than it did on the envelope, but it is just as light as I had hoped it would be. And then we have two. I'm hitting all of the shadow areas. This is my other option if I wanted to use this dark ash. It has a little more brown in it than the magic black has, per my swatching anyway. Cinnamon. This is the color that I think is not as dark. As the barrel. Yeah, see, I think it's a little more orange. Darker than terracotta, but lighter than the barrel. And then we have one darker color. We have the chocolate left. Some areas I'm going very soft. I still want some variation. I want some options. Don't know the pencils all that well, so I can't be guaranteed that I can layer over the top if I use up a lot of the tooth. All right, so next we're going to introduce chocolate 355. And it is definitely matches its barrel. I'm still actually wearing my craft glasses. I wonder if I've got used to doing a really small, these small images. And remember, I was always only doing half of those. So I feel like I need to see more. Oop, and I'm gonna have to clean that up. Some of these lines are awfully thin. So let's see what happens here. This is like my whitest vine to work with. Back to caramel, the lightest color. I am using the caramel to somewhat burnish. Over the top. Trying to leave little tiny bits of white, like on the little nodules. Might have to take the electric eraser and do a little cleanup. And I think I would like a little bit of, if I can get it, some more shadows here. I think that will work. I am doing a once over. I might be able to clean up, brighten up a couple of these flowers maybe. But that's it. Lovely pencils. Very pleasant. More pleasant than the Amazon Basics. I would say, you know, the metallics have their own special place. Derwent Drawing, kind of their own unique thing. So of the last four sets, I'm going to have to give the Artisto. Here's what the logo looks like. The win. And they are very reasonably priced. Now, so are the Amazon Basics. They're, you can get those as inexpensive during sales as $13. I don't remember what I paid for these. In the 20s. Low 20s, maybe? I might have to research that. I might look that up for the review. But in the meantime, do all of the YouTube things like share, comment, and consider subscribing. And we will be back here tomorrow for, I am going to do a day of coloring with Big. We're going to get started. I already shared my background mock-up and plans, and we're just going to dive in. And that will finish off our week of coloring. See you then.